Real quick before I start this episode, I just want to say thank you to Jax Films for picking my submission to his Playlist Live contest as the winner. I cannot believe all of the stuff that has been happening as a result of this. And the only way I can think of to properly thank Jack and all of you wonderful viewers, both old and new, is to just continue chugging out content every week and making said content as high in quality as I can. And with all that said, thank you guys so much, and let's get on with the show. Hello and welcome to another episode of A Brief History. Today's episode, Star Fox. Ready, set, go! March 23rd, 1993, North American game stores received a brand new Super Nintendo game to put on their shelves, and this game was known as Star Fox, or Star Wing, in Europe. Developed by Nintendo's EAD division and Argonaut Software, Star Fox was a simple arcade-style on-rail space shooter starring a crack team of anthropomorphic talking animal fighter pilots known as what else but Star Fox. The original Star Fox team was made up of Fox McCloud, Peppy Hare, Falco Lombardi, and the fan favorite, Slippy Toad.
Boo! You stink!
The main goal of the game was to fly Fox from the beginning of the level to the end in an attempt to defeat the evil masquerade mask Andross. Okay, so I guess he's more of like a giant floating space monkey, but I mean, look at that. That is not the face of a monkey! This game was extremely revolutionary, but not because of the gameplay. As I stated previously, Star Fox was a very simple game, nothing the world hadn't seen before. However, what Star Fox lacked in complexity, it more than made up for in graphical prowess. Star Fox was developed with a special chip called the Super FX, which would allow 3D polygons to be rendered on a console that was only made to run two-dimensional 16-bit graphics, meaning that Star Fox was one of the first fully 3D home console games ever. With Star Fox receiving many a rave review, Nintendo began to work on a sequel simply to be known as Star Fox 2. But even though the game was for the most part finished and slated to be released for the Super Nintendo in 1995, Star Fox 2 was cancelled most likely due to the upcoming release of the Nintendo 64. Nintendo then decided to push the development of the next Star Fox game onto their new 64-bit 3D console, and thus in 1997, Star Fox 64 or Lylat Wars in Europe was presented unto the world. Star Fox 64 improved upon its predecessor in virtually every way. The graphics were better, the controls were better, there were more levels, more ways to play, it introduced the Rumble Pack, and of course, who could forget the absolutely classic voiceovers?
Whoa! Help me!
This can't be happening!
Hit me down! Wait, that was one of ours!
I'll do my best. Andross won't have his way with me.
Andross has ordered us to take you down.
You're a barrel roll!
All of these improvements combined made Star Fox 64 both the quintessential Star Fox game and one of the most celebrated Nintendo classics. In fact, its legacy is still ever present today thanks to the advent and popularization of the internet. Star Fox was now climbing its way up to become one of Nintendo's top-tier franchises. With two classic games that pushed their respective hardware to their limits, it seemed like there was nowhere else for Star Fox to go but up. Unfortunately, it would soon become clear to the world that the opposite of that would be true. It was now 2002, 5 years following the release of Star Fox 64, and Nintendo's new weapon of choice was the GameCube, and it was at this time that gamers were finally greeted with the much-anticipated third installment to the Star Fox series, Star Fox Adventures. But here's where the train begins to veer off of the track. Star Fox Adventures, while still a fantastic game, has garnered an extremely negative reputation due to its strong departure from the style of the first two games. Rather than flying around in a spaceship, Star Fox Adventures found players navigating vast overworlds and dungeons a la The Legend of Zelda. Flying was still very much a part of the experience, but these sections of the game were as short as they were simple and tacked on. All in all, Star Fox Adventures was a good game, but it just was not a Star Fox game. But the question remained, why such a drastic change? Well, as it turned out, Star Fox Adventures was not initially intended to be a Star Fox game. Originally, Adventures was a completely unrelated action-adventure game called Dinosaur Planet. Developed by the British company Rareware, Dinosaur Planet was slated to be the next in Rare's successful line of N64 adventure games, games like Donkey Kong 64, Banjo-Kazooie, and Conker's Bad Fur Day. However, development for Dinosaur Planet was eventually shifted to the GameCube, and the game itself was coded in the Star Fox color. This choice led to the first knock in popularity for Star Fox, and thus it was back to the drawing board for Nintendo. But instead of developing the next Star Fox game themselves, they outsourced the job to Namco, the company best known for the original Pac-Man arcade game. The result of this bizarre decision was Star Fox Assault, released for the Nintendo GameCube on February 14th, 2005. Assault was advertised as a return to Star Fox's SNES and N64 space shooting roots, and while many copies of the game were sold, the continued inclusion of on-foot missions, sloppy controls, and some questionable lineup changes all held the game back for being a true return to form for Star Fox. Alongside the original announcement of Star Fox Assault was Star Fox Arcade, a project that seemingly never got fully off the ground and is assumed to be cancelled. Later that same year at E3, Nintendo announced yet another new Star Fox game. Later that same year at E3, Nintendo announced yet another new Star Fox game known as Star Fox Command, which came out in 2006 for the Nintendo DS. Relying heavily on a strategy and turn-based gameplay mechanic, Command was the first Star Fox game since 1997 to take place solely behind the wheel of a spaceship, and to this day, Command remains the closest Nintendo has come to truly bringing Star Fox back to its roots. And really? That's it! Sales for Star Fox games have been continuously decreasing over the years, and as a result, aside from a 3DS port of Star Fox 64, there have been no new Star Fox games since 2006. Which is a true shame, for in my opinion, all five games in the series are great in their own right, even Star Fox Adventures. And the interest is obviously there. Even series creator Shigeru Miyamoto has said that he would love for there to be a new Star Fox game, but unfortunately, there seem to be absolutely no plans for a new installment to the series. But whether or not... But in the end, whether or not Nintendo ever decides to continue this series, there is no denying the impact these fantastic games have had and continue to have on the gaming landscape and community. I'll see you in a week, guys. DFTBA. Later that same year at E3, Nintendo announced yet another new Star Fox game known as Star Fox Command, which was released in 2006 for the Nintendo DS.
My script fell off the wall. My iPod fell off the wall, and my iPod contains my script.